Good morning. Today we are going to speak about interesting facts about genetics, DNA, grammar and listening. Our lesson objectives are as follows. By the end of the lesson, you will be able to use past models of speculation and deduction, demonstrate understanding specific information in a talk about DNA and genetics. So, first we shall discuss the usage of past models of speculation and deduction, and after that you are going to listen to a text, a dialogue about DNA and genetics and do the tasks. Today we are going to discuss grammar material, past models of speculation and deduction. Сегодня мы узнаем, как образуются модальные глаголы, имеющие прошедшее значение, и с такими выражениями, как размышления и выводы. Let's first study the theory. So, deductions, выводы, assumptions, предположения, must have plus past participle. That is the formula, how to form this modal verb. Almost certain that something was true. Используем, когда мы почти уверены, что что-то было правильное, что что-то произошло. We use the modal verb must plus perfect infinitive for logical assumptions referring to the past. Использую модальный глагол must и перфектный инфинитив для логических заключений, относящихся к прошлому. For example,
she must have been in the sun too long to get so sunburnt.
So, she must have been, должно быть, она слишком много времени провела на солнце, поэтому обгорела. May have plus past participle. Possible that something was true. Возможно, что что-то было правильное. Что-то случилось. То есть степень нашей уверенности уже уменьшается по сравнению с прошлым примером. We use the modal verb may plus perfect infinitive for logical assumptions referring to the past as well. And the example.
He may have broken his leg while skiing.
Возможно, он сломал ногу, когда катался на коньках, на лыжах, sorry. So may have broken. Can't have plus past participle is used to express almost certainty that something was impossible. Почти уверенность выражаем, когда в том, что что-то навряд ли случилось, невероятно. We use the modal verb can't plus perfect infinitive for logical assumptions referring to the past as well. And the example.
Flying in such bad weather can't have been a very pleasant experience for passengers and crew.
Мы почти уверены, что навряд ли летать на самолетах в такую плохую погоду доставляет удовольствие пассажирам и членам экипажа. So, that is almost certain. We are almost certain that something was impossible. And now, let's have a look at this table once again. Tom isn't in the library. He must have gone home. I'm sure it happened. That is deduction. Это выводы. То есть мы уверены, что это так и было. В том, что это случилось. He must have gone home. Должно быть уверены почти в том, что он пошел домой. Должно быть пошел домой. Kelly isn't at home. She might, may, could have gone to the supermarket. So, three variants are possible here. We may say, she might have gone to the supermarket. She may have gone to the supermarket and she could have gone to the supermarket. And the meaning of these expressions, I am not sure. That is speculation. Это наши размышления. Мы не очень уверены в том, что мы говорим. Возможно, предположим, может быть, пошла в магазин. You can't have seen Beric at work this morning. He's on holiday. I'm sure it didn't happen. That is deduction. Навряд ли вы видели Берика на работе сегодня утром. Навряд ли вы это там видели. He's on holiday. У него выходной. Возможно, это и так, но я уверен в том, что навряд ли это случилось. It didn't happen. Well, now let us come back to our text and have examples more. Jack and his team must have been amazed because it suggested that DNA lasts a lot longer than originally believed. So, must have been amazed. What does this refer to? What does this refer to? Does it express speculation or deduction? So, speculation, размышление, or deduction, или выводы, заключения. Speculation is used when we are not so sure, and deduction when we are almost sure that this happened. So, this example shows that that is a deduction. It refers to a deduction. Это выводы. То есть большая степень вероятности в том, что что-то произошло. And now let us do some exercise. Use the prompts and the verbs in brackets to complete the sentences with the past modals. Harry looks upset. He has some bad news. And the prompt in bracket, I am not sure. That is speculation. I am not sure. Sentence number 2. My bicycle isn't there. Someone steal it. I'm sure it happened. Sentence 3. This book is 600 pages long. You read it in one day. I'm sure it didn't happen. Sentence 4. There is a cake in the fridge. Mom, go to the supermarket. I'm sure it happened. So, look at the prompts in brackets and complete the sentences using the past modals. Now we're going to listen to a text about Jack and Amy. They are talking about a lecture on DNA. And for questions 1-4, choose the correct answer A, B or C. Let's listen to the text.
What did you think of the lecture, Amy?
It was really interesting, Jack, especially the part about gene editing. I was born with asthma and it's no fun, I can tell you. The idea that we'll be able to remove the bad genes responsible for diseases from an unborn baby is a huge advance for medical science. I know that some people disagree with it now, but I think everyone will be doing it in the future.
I know what you mean, but it's not that simple, is it?
What do you mean?
There might be problems. Removing one gene from a cell may affect the other genes. Each of our cells contains a huge amount of information. How do we know that? By taking out a bad gene from a cell. The scientists are not also taking out a good one. They have no idea what damage that could cause.
Genetic editing is a major breakthrough, Jack. I'm sure that in the future the scientists won't make mistakes.
You can't be sure about that. Look at Jurassic Park.
What? That's a film. That could never happen.
I know it's a film, but they used gene editing in it to create the dinosaurs. They created something they couldn't control, and it destroyed them. I've read that scientists are trying to revive dinosaurs for real now. That can't be a good idea, can it?
Okay, I get your point. We have to be careful with any new science. We don't know what people will use it for, but that's true of every discovery and invention since the Stone Age.
To be honest, Amy, I can't decide whether altering DNA is a good thing or not. They're also considering using the science to bring back other extinct species. Not ones from millions of years ago, but more recently extinct ones, like the woolly mammoth.
Now that's something I'd love to see. A hairy elephant.
So, now let us do the task.
The idea that we'll be able to remove the bad genes responsible for diseases from an unborn baby is a huge advance for medical science.
So, what does Amy think about gene editing? Listen to this part once again.
The idea that we'll be able to remove the bad genes responsible for diseases from an unborn baby is a huge advance for medical science.
So, sentence number two. What does Jack say about scientists?
How do we know that? By taking out a bad gene from a cell. The scientists are not also taking out a good one. They have no idea what damage that could cause.
So, have you decided yet? Listen to the text once again.
How do we know that? By taking out a bad gene from a cell. The scientists are not also taking out a good one. They have no idea what damage that could cause.
So once more, the next sentence, listen to the text.
Okay, I get your point. We have to be careful with any new science.
So Amy says that, listen to the text again.
Okay, I get your point. We have to be careful with any new science.
So now the last sentence here. How does Jack feel about gene editing?
To be honest, Amy, I can't decide whether altering DNA is a good thing or not.
So listen to the text once again.
To be honest, Amy, I can't decide whether altering DNA is a good thing or not.
Today in the lesson, you have learned how to use past models of speculation and deduction. You have listened to the talk about DNA and genetics and done some tasks. Your home task, lesson tasks, will be like follows. Exercise 6, page 11. Complete the sentences with the past models. And exercise 7, page 11 as well. Choose the correct answer.